Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So I'll be telling you the things that I love about my Hyundai Eon, so let's go! I apologize if I keep on slapping the camera. I just thought night school and you know. I apologize for that. It's my thing. So sorry. This video is a response to a video that I filmed a couple of weeks ago. Now, yung other video na yon is labeled the things that I hate about my Hyundai Eon. I'll be posting the thumbnail somewhere on the screen, maybe dito. And as the title suggests, that's all about the things that I don't like about this car right here. I just feel na my video lineup is not going to be complete unless I make a video discussing the things that I love about this car. So tara, pag-usapan natin ang mga bagay na I love about my Hyundai Eon. But before that, syempre, quick montage muna tayo. Let's go! Alright, so the first thing that I love about this car right here is how affordable it is. Now, this particular unit, we bought it for 230,000 pesos and that was just a couple of months ago. It's a car from 2018 and when we got the car, it only had 24,000 kilometers on the clock. So just imagine guys, I was able to buy this car for 230,000 pesos and it's only 4 years old. Imagine buying a car for 4 years old tapos 230,000 pesos. Ang baba pa ng mileage. So that right there really makes me happy. So that's the reason why I had to mention that on my video. The second thing that I love about this car is yung availability ng parts. When before we made the purchase, I made some research. I checked kung gaano ka available ang parts nitong kotse na to. And what I found out is yung mga parts niya are available almost anywhere. At least these days kasi medyo matagal na din tong kotseng to sa market. I mean, I've heard na before medyo mahirap yung pyesa. Pero these days, I've heard na parts are available everywhere. May mga nagpa-parts out na, available din ang parts niya sa Shopee and sa Lazada. And the prices of the parts, it's not that bad. Moving on, the third thing on my list would be yung ground clearance niya. Now this thing has got 170 millimeter of ground clearance. Now, 170 millimeters is not really all that high. Pero that height is also enough for you to not worry about speed bumps. Siguro, as long as siguro, apat lang yung sakay, tapos wala kayong masyadong luggage, tapos hindi naman kabigatan yung mga kasunog, yung mga nakasakay sa likod, then that would enable you to clear yung mga speed bumps dito sa mga daan natin. Fourth on my list would be how compact the car is. Now, ito na yung part wherein its weakness becomes its strength. Kasi nga, since maliit yung kotse, I mean, obviously, maliit siya, it's now easy to park. Andaling kumanap ng parking space. It's also easy to maneuver sa mga tight spaces. Kasi nga, yun, maliit. Since maliit yung kotse, syempre, mas madali ding linisin. Now, that part I really love. Before, doon sa dati kong sasakyan, syempre, since mas malaki, edi I spend more time cleaning it, pero with this car ay sobrang bilis lang compared to the other cars that I had. At syempre, one thing that I love about the car is when you're inside, since maliit yung kotse, pag nasa loob ka, halos abot mo lahat sa loob. I mean, when you, let me just demonstrate. So, when you're inside the car, right? For example, this car does not have power locks just yet. So, let's say for example, may sasakay, tapos nakalock yung door, you can easily reach yung mga door locks. Kahit yung sa likod, eh, oh. So yun, kung ilalak mo naman, talagang ang andaling abutin ng mga bagay-bagay sa loob. Pag may naiwanan ka sa likod na upuan, yan, you can easily reach stuff. Andali lang. And again, that is because the car is so small. Alright, so the fifth thing that I love about this car is how easy it is to drive. Now for that, tara sa loob ng kotse and then I will demonstrate. Okay, mainit na rin naman sa labas, so let's get inside the car real quick. Okay, Jesus. It's really hot outside. The reason why I said na this thing is easy to drive is because ang lambot ng clutch. Super lambot ng clutch. Ang ano din, ang ikli din ng throw ng shifter. So, parang naka-short shift siya. And at the same time, napaka-lambot ng manibela. I mean, let me demonstrate ito. I'm going to approach this street right here. Liliko ako. And check this out. With one finger, naliliko ko yung sasakyan. Check this out. Kahit nakatigil yung sasakyan, let me just check with one finger. I was able to turn the steering wheel. Syempre kaya naman malambot yung steering is because ano siya. Electric na yung power steering niya. Saka contributor to that would be the fact na I'm still using yung stock na ano niya, stock na gulong, which is just 155 70. So makipot lang yung gulong niya, narrow lang, kaya it's easier for you to turn the steering wheel. Pero of course, as soon as you modify your tires, kapag pinalapad mo yan, syempre it's going to be a bit more difficult for you to turn the steering wheel. Pero ito nga, in its stock form with 155 70, the tires, you know, turning the wheel, the steering wheel, I mean, is very, very easy. Check that out. Kaya that's the reason why I said na this car is very, very easy to drive. Alright, since we're inside the car, let me tell you about I was about to do the gesture for number 6, pero I just realized that I don't have enough fingers in one hand. So, yeah. Anyway, the sixth thing that I like about the car would be how comfortable and supportive the seats are dito sa kotse na to. Contributor dyan would be, I think, itong bolstering dito sa side. It really holds you in place when you're driving. Tapos malambot din, so it's not really all that bad. Komportable na rin kahit long drives. And you know what? The design is not all that bad kasi, I mean, check this out. Check this out. Para siyang bucket seats. Tapos yan, straight out from the factory, leather na siya. So napaka-presentable and it's also very easy to clean. So those are the things that makes me like these seats very much. Okay, moving on. Now the seventh thing that I love about this tiny car right here would be yung air conditioning niya. For a car this size, with its price range, malamig yung air conditioning niya. At least for this car, I don't know how other Eon owners think about their units, pero this car, malamig yung air conditioning niya. Na-mention ko nga lang on another video, yung dun sa video ko na about the things that I don't love about or the things that I hate about the car. Medyo mahirap lang i-divert or i-direct rather yung air. Let's say gusto mong itutok sa mukha mo, it's really hard to direct the air. Pero yung hangin na lumalabas sa vents, malamig siya and it's enough to cool the whole car down. Even nung time na wala akong tint, malamig, napapalamig niya talaga. Ito nga lang usually yung setting ko. Kahit tanghali, ito yung thermostat hanggang dito lang. Tapos yun, at most, I would go number 2 or siguro number 3 kapag kababagong pasok lang sa kotse. Yun, number 3. Tapos, after a couple of moments, yan, nababalik ko na sa number 2 or even number 1. Kaya na niya. So yun, okay yung air conditioning niya. Okay, so yun. That would be my list of the things that I love about this car right here. I would also appreciate if other Eon owners would comment the things that they love about their car. Para guide na rin sa mga tao na gustong bumili ng ganitong klaseng sasakyan. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you made it this far, and kung gusto mo rin lang naman ng mga car-related contents, please hit the like button. And please subscribe to my channel because as I always say, I make these videos just for you. Bye-bye!